Now here's something we've seen a couple times already just in passing. We're in System Management Tools and we want to look at the Point Builder. So if I go into the Point section and choose Point Builder, here's the graphical user interface for building PI tags. I would add, here's the interface for building tags one at a time. If you've got 10,000 tags to point, nobody would, or to build, nobody would build it using this tool. It would just take too long. But to create tags or edit existing tags, I can use this to search for existing tags or just choose new and then just create a new tag. So I'll call this my test one, and I would assign it all the proper attributes, you know, based on my needs. So for example, let's pretend I'm creating a laboratory tag. I'll choose point source of lab, and I'll make this, let's say this is a this is going to be a float 32, and for the engineering units we'll say that this is measuring parts per million, and this is my test for class manual input tag. Now there's all types of attributes, and we're going to look at these attributes as we go through and study the different tag attributes, things like source tag for outputs, etc. But I'll just stick with some of the basics here. I've given it a name. I need to give it a zero and a span, and an engineering unit. The default is zero, span of 100. So let's say this is actually going from 0 to 40,000. And the typical value is around 25,000. And then, you know, depending on what my needs are, I can set the compression settings as I like. For example, with a laboratory tag, I would probably set compressing turned equal to off. And for a lab tag also, I probably wouldn't even worry about the exception deviation. It wouldn't make any difference because there's no interface involved here. It's simply something that's being added manually. So I would go through and change all the attributes that are necessary. Classic is where we go to change those settings required for specific interfaces. Now that's a pretty bland statement. We haven't described this at all yet because basically you can't describe this until you start discussing a specific interface. So in this class we use the OPC interface as an example. Later when we create OPC tags, we'll come back, we'll take a look at them as an example of what you would put in these fields for instrument tag and location codes, etc. So these are all the different parameters. Security settings, these are those system parameters. It looks like you can edit these, but you can't. These are just read-only fields. And once I'm good and set, this looks good, I'll go ahead and save this. And now that I've saved it, it becomes a PI tag that I can use in any application. So for example, I could go out to Processbook and launch Processbook and add this, or I can go into, let's go look at the recorded values for this. I'll go out and look for all the tags that begin with the letters MY. And we find my test one. And so let's see if we can get the events. And here it is. It's been created, so it has a single value, and that is the digital state point created. So that's how I create a tag, one tag at a time.